Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey and you're watching another Proshow Gold tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to make a scrolling effect using images that scroll up the screen and then get replaced by another image, like that. Now it may look like this is fairly complicated, but trust me, this is really straightforward. And don't worry, I'm going to show you all the steps you need to create an effect exactly the same as this. Okay, let's start off by making a blank show with nothing in it at all. Right, so I've got a few pictures that I want to scroll up the screen. I've already sized them in Photoshop so they're all exactly the same dimensions. Now that's really important because it makes the job of putting these together so much easier. Okay, so let's bring it onto the screen. Let's start off with this picture here. They're all pictures taken on a holiday to Venice. Now the idea is that this picture should scroll up from the bottom. Now, to make that happen, we're going to use motion effects. So let's bring those onto the screen. Let's double click our little slide down here. And on the slide options, make sure you're working on the motion tab, which we have active now. Now, to make this move around, you can either click it or drag it, like so. But if you want to be really accurate, and we do need to be really accurate, you can enter dimensions up here. Now, the panning is the left to right and up and down motion. Now the first set of numbers is the left to right. Now I don't want it to go left to right. If that's the sort of motion you want, this is the one you change. I want mine to go up and down. So I'm going to put 0 in the first set of numbers. Now the next one controls the height. The bigger the number, the lower down it is. So if I put in, for example, 90, you'll see that my picture drops right down to the bottom of the screen. Put in 100, and it drops just off the edge of the screen. 99, you'd see a little strip. 100, you can't see a thing. So the motion effect is from the bottom of the screen and it's going to end up at the top of the screen here. And we'll click done. Okay, let's see that on our little preview. And you can see it comes up onto the screen and then it fades away. Now that's not quite the effect we want. The reason it's fading is because the current dissolve is set to an AB fade with a 3 second fade built in. Now if we change that to 0 seconds and play it through, it comes onto the screen a lot faster, gets to the top and then vanishes. Now that's fine. I actually want it to run a little bit quicker still, so I'm going to change the duration of that slide from 3 seconds to 2 seconds, so it now runs a little bit quicker up the screen. But when it gets to the screen, we don't want it to disappear. When it gets to the top, we want it to stay on the screen. So let's get the same picture that we've already used and drag it down onto the next slide along. Now it should go in for 2 seconds and it should have the fade time also set to 0. So that should happen automatically, which it has. So when we play it this time, it moves up the screen, stays there for 2 seconds and then disappears. Well, we're getting there. I want it to now go out the top of the screen. So we're going to get the same slide again, drag it on to the next slide along and double click it. Let's go back to the motion effects. So it starts here as a full screen image and this time we want it to flow out the top of the picture. Now once again I'm going to leave the first set of numbers at 0 and the second set on the pan I'm going to put to minus 100. So again minus 99, you'd see a little thin slice at the top. Minus 100 is just off the edge of the screen. And we'll click done. Right, let's play back from the beginning. So again, it rises up, it stays for 2 seconds, and then it flies out the top of the screen. Great, okay, that's working really well. But we need another picture to come in behind it. You can see on our little slide here that there's black underneath it. And this is just the first of a sequence, not the last. So let's get another picture. I'm going to get this one here, which is my next picture along, and I'm going to add this in to the currently last slide. Now I'm going to do that by making it a layer, and to do that you hold Control on the keyboard, drag that image down and drop it onto the slide that's at the end, like so. Now it seems to cover up our picture, but don't worry, it's now made a layer. Let's double click that and we'll go back to the motion effects. Now this one has to start at the bottom and move up to the top. So it's going to be 100, not 10, 100, there we go. And it's going to end up at 0. Okay, let's double check it works. And we'll start it from there. And bingo. Yeah, that works fine. But once again, it suddenly stops. So we need to have that slide there for another 2 seconds. So it flies up the screen, pauses for 2 seconds, and now it has to fly out the top. So let's bring it on and double click it. And we'll change the last set of numbers on the pan to minus 100 and click done. Now you can see how this is working. This seems very familiar to the last one we did. And in fact, it's exactly the same setup as before. So when you come along to this slide, again, we don't want it to finish in black. So we'll hold control on the keyboard, drag this onto the last slide in our sequence, double click it to go back to the motion effects. And again, this one starts at 100, ends at 0. And then we'll need this one onto its own slide to stay there for 2 seconds. And then we need it to fly out the top. So once you've done a few of these, you can quickly start to build up speed and keep using the same process over and over again. So let's bring this one in here. That's going to be its own little layer. It's going to start at the bottom. Done. And then it's going to end up on its own, like so. Okay, so there we go. Let's just see if that works. So we start at the beginning, it scrolls up, it stays put, and it gets replaced by another slide. And yes, another slide. Oh, look at that. It works like a charm. And so on. Okay, so that's fine. And that's got a nice constant flow. But if you want to speed things up or slow things down, you can change the timings. So for example, you can have a faster sliding in and out by changing the time from 2 seconds to 1 second. You can have it paused on the screen for longer, and you'll know those images because those are the ones where an image fits the entire slide on your little slide list down here. So I'm going to make those 3 seconds, and I'm going to make the ones where it's sliding 1 second. So that should just change the durations a little bit. And that's going to be a 1 second, that's going to be a 3, that's a 1, and that's a 3. Okay, so that should now run faster up the screen, stay put, and then run a little bit quicker, like so. So you can change the speed of your slideshow to match your audio and to keep it flowing nicely. And you can put any timings in there you like. You can change the timings that pictures stay on the screen for to try and break up the monotony of it a little bit and just play around and see what great slideshows you can come up with.